Hello, I'm Mr. Armiger, editor lecture in metallurgy in Christianity, and this is the number 5 videos in the role played by Christ Jesus. The previous video was interrupted by a telephone call, so I made it short. So here I'm going to finish that up, that Hazrat Mohammed Sahib, he was a Gentile, and he was clean-hearted person. He was more spiritual than the book people, God-fearing. So he was given the introduction to the real Christianity or the real message of Christ Jesus by a monk called Monk Bahira. In the real Christianity, you have to do the will of our Father, not your own will. Whereas these bishops and popes sitting in the churches, they started to do their own wills, killing people before animals, making these nonsense Nicene Creed and all that to bind the people. So what they were doing, they were all doing anti-Christ activities. To put a stop to these activities, then Hazrat Mohammed Sahib, he organized a small group of party, and as I explained previously, they invaded one village, and as they subdued, and so they carried on with this expansion. So this Islam of Muhammad Sahib, it is a moon and star, it is a mullah and not of Allah. In the Islam of Allah, it is Inshallah that dominates. But in the Islam which Hazrat Muhammad Sahib created, it was the fatwas of Mullah or the will of the Mullah that was forced upon the people. So it was you remember the moon, John the Baptist was the moon, and star are the angels. So here was this, then a priest was established, a mullah was established in this Islam, who were became the master. Depending upon the quality of this mullah, whether he was greedy or not greedy, it worked well against what Pope was doing. Pope was the greediest of all the person that you can see today. How big he has the Vatican Empire. He became the authoritarian, kingmaker, and all that, the third temptation of Christ Jesus, when he was taken to the high mountain, shown all the worldly kingdoms. So this Antichrist Pope had gone for the worldly kingdoms, and as in the worldly kingdom, when you expand it, you have to kill people. So he was killing people in the name of Jesus by putting them before animals and all that. However, these two Antichrist, they created havoc in the world. And when they created havoc, and it came this Islam of Mullah, when it was introduced to East, to India, in India, over there the people of the Khatri tribes, which were educated, when they took over this Islam, and then they misused it to their greatest will, and that created havoc in the world, or havoc in India especially, where these Khatris were misusing the Islam. So when they start committing atrocities, and then these Mohammedan rulers, when they used to attack India, they used to kill people. Then the second anointed Christ in the name of Nanak appeared to put a stop to this nonsense. So second anointed Christ, Nanak Devji, appeared in the Punjab, and he preached the same thing as Christ Jesus had done, But in this case, it was in six forms. So the last form of Nanak was Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji. Satguru means Christ. But these Khatris have told people to address Satguru Nanak Dev Ji as Guru. Guru means a moral teacher. Nanak was not a moral teacher, but a spiritual preacher. He was not a rabbi, as Christ Jesus was not a rabbi. So the people were misled, and then the Khatris, they created a great havoc in India. As Nanak preached the gospel of Kalpurakh, or God, the Khatris became stronger, and they put a greater resistance to the preaching of gospel. Remember when Paul was preaching gospel, all the local Jews used to get together and put a resistance to him and used to stone him and almost killed him. So same way, you know, these Khatris, when they became mullahs, they exploited the Quran, and then they created a greater havoc in India. So the Nanak has to take six forms in order to introduce the real word of God. And it took him 150 years to preach gospel, whereas Christ Jesus had done just in 3 to 4 years. So you can well imagine how strong was the Antichrist or satanic people in India, created by this Islam of Muhammad, in which moon and star, moon mean the mullah, star mean the angels, perfect in moral laws, were worshipped. The real Islam is of sun, the primary source of light, which is called Allah. So in that, Allah is a inshallah. In mullah, we have inshmullah Islam. So that created havoc. So in the East, we have Christ Nanak, or Satguru Nanak Devi, in six forms, who again stressed the same thing as Christ Jesus had done, but much deeper in philosophy. So that this philosophy is a bit not easy to understand, as it is easy to understand the New Testament or the Gnostic Gospels. So if you have any Sikh who say he is a real Sikh, Sikh means a student of spiritual knowledge, if he has learned something, he should not find any problem in interpreting the parables. But most of them are just Sikhs of a turban and beard, and that is false. So these are the Sikhs that create problems, sectarian riots, and all that you see in India, they are created by them. So they are fanatic. So fanaticism means that more dangerous than you can expect. What you expect in Sikhism, that if somebody hits you on one cheek, present the other. But over there, they being the next prophet had also come, which was Royal King Gobind Singh Ji, about which I will tell you in the next video. And he created Khalsas, which have to take sword power. So these Sikhs are keeping swords on them, as if they have some enemy to fight, whereas a Sikh has no stranger or enemy to him. So they are more confused than the people of the Middle East. So then that's why you see them calling me bad names when I preach gospel, because they are more fanatic than the people of the Middle East. God bless you.